Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. God bless you guys. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, some of you who are new to my channel, I listen to all kinds of music. I like modern praise music, old music, anything that's anointed. And how does it get anointed? By the singers. The Bible says the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of His people. So it's not the songs, but the anointed of those who are singing. It's not someone who knows the 23rd Psalm about the Good Shepherd, just like Jesus talks about Himself as the Good Shepherd in John chapter 10. The 23rd Psalm is about the Good Shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. It's not he who knows that psalm, but he who knows the one who gave that psalm, the one who knows the Good Shepherd. Hallelujah. You can smell the fragrance of the Lord on those who have been with Jesus. Hallelujah. Just like when Peter and John were before the Sanhedrin, we see in Acts chapter 4 and verse 5, Acts chapter 4 and 5, and it said, you know, because they had performed this miracle, the gate called Beautiful, there was a man that was lame, and he was already like in his 40s, and they had prayed and he was healed. And then they said, you know, they knew they had been with Jesus. You know, they knew that they had been with Jesus besides the miracles that they did. And the apostle, Luke, the physician Luke, who wrote the book of Acts, said that, you know, Peter, being filled with the Holy Spirit, stood and began to speak. And when Stephen spoke to the Sanhedrin, Acts chapter 7 and 8, it says that when he stood to speak, he was filled with the Holy Spirit, and they perceived his face as if it was the face of an angel. Hallelujah. See, because that fragrance of the Lord is upon his people. Hallelujah. That's why, brothers and sisters, listen to me. He who has an ear, let him hear. That's why I'm always, you know, tripping out, as they say. I think about how the people... You know, the Lord always leads me in my messages. I wasn't even going to talk about this, of course. But, you know, it's like when Peter went in there and he denied the Lord, you know, and he followed. If you read the Gospel of John, you'll see that John was a friend of the high priest, the Apostle John. And so he was able to go in there when Jesus was on trial before the high priest in the middle, you know, when they took him at nighttime from the Garden of Gethsemane. He went there and Peter kind of followed along behind. You know, and the Lord had already told him he would deny him three times before the cock crow. So when Peter went in there, it says he warmed his hands over the fire. You know, then he was denying the Lord. And that always reminds me of these denominational people, brothers and sisters. I can't help it, but that's what the Lord wants me to talk about. I don't care that I don't have, you know, an hysterical, overhyped news network and that I have 50,000 or 80,000 subscribers. Doesn't matter to me, brothers and sisters. But that I would speak as the Lord would lead me to speak about the Word of God, not about the bad news of what's on television and internet, but the good news of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And so, brothers and sisters, when Peter was there warming his hands by the fires, but yet denying the Lord, it's just like those people that would come in and you know, and they want to be around people that are anointed. They want to be around. You know, they know it's the Holy Spirit. If you're born again, if you're saved, you know, you've had a taste of the Holy Spirit, you know, just an earnest, as it's called, a down payment or a taste of the Holy Spirit. And so you know the presence of the Holy Spirit. But when you get want to be around and get into the path of a river of living water flowing out of the belly of those who have been baptized in the Holy Spirit and you know, get in the warmth of the glow of the Lord upon his people. See, because the fragrance of the Lord, the anointing of the Lord, the glow of the Lord is upon those who are walking with Him. Hallelujah. But what the Lord wants you to do, you who have a form of godliness but deny the power thereof, you who are in the back row back there, you know, spying out what's going on through the internet, God wants you to come up closer to Him. The Lord Jesus wants you to walk with Him. See, that's why, you know, you're enjoying the anointing because I've been walking with Jesus. But He wants you to walk with Him also. Hallelujah. For Jesus is God. He can walk with 10 million people. He can walk with 1 billion people at the same time. Hallelujah. There is no limit to how many people that the Lord Jesus Christ can walk with and talk with in the cool of the day. Hallelujah. For the Lord is calling each and every one of you to come up here. Come up here and walk with Him. Hallelujah. Come up here and He will show you things that are to come. Hallelujah. Revelation 4:1. Hallelujah. The Lord wants you to walk with Him, brothers and sisters. Get close to Him. Hallelujah. Stop warming your hands by the fire outside, you know, and peeping in there. And then when someone asks you, oh, do you believe in speaking in tongues? Oh, no, I don't think that's for today. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, no. But yet you're right there warming your hands by the fire, peeping in on what Jesus is doing, peeping in on what's going on. But yet denying the Lord when it comes down to those moments. Hallelujah. When we become ashamed, as Paul says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I've done many videos on that. What is the gospel? Well, it's the good news of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. But also, brothers and sisters, this text is coming back to me about the supernatural power of God. Hallelujah. When the Apostle Paul in the books of Acts, and I believe it's Acts chapter 16, was here when he was at Lystra, it says there he preached the gospel. It says Paul was there and he preached the gospel. In the next verse it says, then he saw a man who was lame in his feet since birth, sitting there watching him, and it said Paul, the Apostle Paul, perceived that the man had faith to be healed. So Paul said to him, In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, arise and walk. And the man was healed. He stood and leaped and praised God. So brothers and sisters, when Paul the apostle was preaching the gospel, this man who was lame got the faith to be physically healed. That's why we call it full gospel. That's why when you see a church, sometimes they'll say, oh, we're a full gospel church. What does that mean? They teach the full gospel, not just about being born again, but that Jesus has gone about doing good and healing all that were sick, the Bible says. Hallelujah. That by His stripes we were healed, physical healing, the gifts of the Spirit, all of those things. That's why the Apostle Paul told us, brothers and sisters, in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 1 through 5, he said, I didn't come to you with excellency of speech, you know, in wisdom and knowledge of men. But I came to you in power of the Holy Spirit and demonstrations of the power of the Holy Spirit, that your faith might not rest in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. Hallelujah. That your faith will be in the power of God, the manifested power of God, brothers and sisters. These signs shall follow those that believe. Mark chapter 16, Jesus talking, in my name they'll cast out devils. They'll speak with new tongues. They'll lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Brothers and sisters, the Lord keeps leading me to challenge you. To challenge you to stop living vicariously through others. You know, that's what's so amazing. There's a brother who's Andy Firecharger. You know, I don't watch anybody's videos. I've seen one or two of his videos. And the reason why brother Andy Firecharger, the truck driver, is popular, it's because he'll go out and pray for somebody to be healed. And then he'll make a video and say, hey, I went and I stopped at this truck stop. There was a dude and I told him about Jesus. The guy wanted to get saved. He got healed and praise the Lord. People are fascinated by that. But every Christian should be doing that, brothers and sisters. That's the point. As Sid Ross says, you know, it's naturally supernatural. Every Christian should be operating in the power of God. Now, I just want to add this on here. I want to say this on here. Because I had a sister who just talked to me about this yesterday via message that she had prayed with someone and they weren't healed. We were talking about it. It comes to find out, and you know, this sister, she's going to correct this. She needs to get married. She has her boyfriend and they're in a very close relationship, let's put it that way, and they're not married. Now, I instructed her by the grace of God as a pastor of God that she needs to correct that situation immediately. And she is going to do that, praise God. But there are things that can hinder our walk with God. And, you know, let me just switch over to that. I want to say that. Not about this sister, because this sister is going to correct it. I want to say this. Most people, not all, but most people who I'm talking to, who watch my videos, you're sitting on the back row. The problem that hinders lots of people, your denominational people, is because they do not want to walk. They, you know, when you come, let me just say this. I'm trying to think of the one-liner to say this. When you come to Jesus, you can't bring your sin with you because you're going to get burned up. When you get close to the sun, you're going to get burned up. You know, it was like that, you know, this old devil story about what's his name? You know this guy, is it Copernicus? Whatever, he made his wings and he put wax on there and he tried to fly to the sun, and then the sun was hot and it melted the wax and his wings fell off and he crashed and died, whatever. It's like that, brothers and sisters. See, when you are trying to make your own wings, when you're trying to be covered just like Adam and Eve with their fig leaves, and you try to have your own covering over your sin, and you try to be a self-righteous old hypocrite, old Pharisee, which most of these old religious people are, you try to ease up on Jesus, and when you get close to the sun, well, your olive leaf is going to get all burnt up. Your wax and your homemade wings that you're trying to fly, not in the power of the Holy Spirit, but in the power of your flesh, you're going to get burnt up. That's why we have all these false prophets on YouTube. Little bug in here. Brothers and sisters, that's why we have all these false prophets on YouTube. They, talking about how they're prophesying for God, they're operating in the gifts of the Spirit. They wouldn't know they don't know the Holy Spirit. Many of these people, it's the lust of the flesh and the pride of life that's driving this kind of internet fame and notoriety, brothers and sisters. Lots of these people, you know, they grab a hold of something like the latest thing is the Jade Helm. There's another group that says all kinds of stuff about they're one of the 144,000 witnesses, even though they're Gentiles. There is one guy. I'm not going to name names, but there's one guy that says that him and his buddy, these two effeminate young guys, and they're on this, they do some radio interviews. I've seen on YouTube, someone told me to listen to them because they believe them. These two effeminate boys said that they've been going to heaven and that they too are archangels, and they even have their names as archangels. They're humans born on earth. But when they went to heaven, they found out that they're really archangels, both of them. And then they have their archangel names, and that they can draw a flower, and then it'll turn into a real flower. They can draw a bird, it'll turn into a bird and fly away. All this new age. And thousands of people are watching these videos believing this stuff, brothers and sisters. The Lord is coming back for His bride, and I pray it is this year. I pray that the Lord will come for us this year. You know, brothers and sisters, I advise you, don't look at the things that's going on in this world. Look up on the Lord Jesus Christ. Focus on the good news, not the bad news. That's why all these people, the most popular people on YouTube, the top people that a lot of you guys love to follow, they do not believe in the rapture. They don't believe in the pre-tribulation rapture. That's why I caution you. Let's get on the good news. Let's get on the good news of Jesus Christ. I might scrap this old.